Greetings, I'm Caffeine Rage, and I'm back with the Sunday Sampler. This week, we're taking a quick look at Tabletop Racing World Tour. This is a self-published title by Playrise Digital Limited, and I've got a review copy of the PC version, but this is also out on consoles as well, so you can check it out there if you want. But I think a lot of my criticism, and yes, there is going to be a lot of criticism of this game, probably stems from me being a PC player, to be perfectly frank. Here we are at the main menu of the game, and you may notice that there's something missing here. There is a complete lack of custom races. There are these special events which are interesting, but they are locked to a single car with a single track type, well, a single track and a single mode. You don't have a way of building a custom race, which is a huge detriment to me because there is not a ton of content here in this game. There is a fair amount, I will say that. This isn't a bare bones racing game. This actually has some interesting ideas about it and it has a fair amount to go for the price tag. That said, the complete lack of custom play mode is just amazing to me. Anyway, let's go ahead and jump into the garage and we'll take a look at the cars and see what we have here. There are 12 cars total in the base game. They do have a day one DLC, which I'll reserve my judgment on that, mostly because I don't have a review copy of it, so. But the cars are split into three categories, as you can see. Cult Classics, which has a couple puns like Breaking's Bad, and I'm pretty sure that's the Starsky and Hutch car. Street Racing and Supercars. I've so far only unlocked Street Racers. I've got one pretty much maxed out after about, I want to say, 2 hours or so, and that's just not me really even grinding to try to get the best bang for my buck. That's just me going through the game. And there is some grind in this game, I will say that much. Because you have a player level which does lock out some of these special events as you could. Whoops, I went back a little too far. As you can see, these special events are tied to level. This one, you need to be level 5 to get. That one's level 7. That one's level 8. So, at level, you will be grinding out some to be unlocking some content. Let's go ahead and just pop back in, and I'll go to my upgraded car. You could upgrade across 4 different areas. I've not a clue what armor does, to be perfectly frank. This is a combat racer, but it seems like that compared to my base level car, which was, I took this one because I only had a choice between these two to start. I needed like 100 more coins to start that one, and I grabbed that one later on. I'm pretty sure I upgraded the armor on one of these and I didn't notice a huge difference. Yeah, I upgraded the armor on this. Honestly, I didn't see a difference at all, so I'm not sure if armor is supposed to reduce the time that weapons affect you or what's going on there. Some tooltips would have been very handy. So anyway, let's go ahead. Oh, no, I don't want to buy that. Go ahead and go back to this. So you have the three basic stats and armor, which, like I said, has no idea. And then you have this system, which is kind of interesting. This is wheel weapons, which unlocking these wheels is very expensive, but it also, essentially think of it as basically going across your entire profile. These can be used on any car that you've unlocked. So you have standard wheels and drift wheels. This is, drift wheels are pretty much for the drifting event, unless you really like drifting around corners, which I'll be perfectly frank, I'm not much of a drifter, so I don't exactly use these outside of the necessary events, which we'll get to in a little bit. Bling wheels, which increases your money. Shield wheels, which takes the place of a shield power-up on the track itself, which I have to say that is a nice touch. Because it's always a little disappointing to get a shield power-up whenever you're trying to shoot someone. So having the shield be a power-up that you can get on the side, and not terribly expensive, I mean, that is still fairly expensive, but still. having that shield be completely separate is a welcome change. Centurion wheels, which allows you to just ram people to the side and kill them. But it is a very short time, it seems. I'll be perfectly honest, I haven't bought any of these tires, so I'm not 100% sure of how well they perform. Jumping tires, which is exactly what it says on the tin, and for some tracks, that is pretty much a requirement to get some of the shortcuts, so you'll see some shortcuts that require what looks to be an impossible jump, and that's what these are for. And then piece wheels, which basically takes the weapons out of the game for every so often. And honestly, the AI picks on you a huge amount in this game. It's one of these games where everyone gangs up on the human player, particularly with the weapons. In my a couple hours of playing before recording this, I've only seen the AI shoot weapons at other AIs just a handful of times. It makes the combat racing feel a bit out of place just because all the weapons are going towards you. I'm not sure if the AI is being overly conservative with its weapons and waiting for that perfect shot to go off, or what's going on with it. But that is something that I think they should take a look at, along with the custom game mode. So let's go ahead and pop into the championships. You have to do these in order, so you can't, if you get enough money during the cult classes, you can't skip the second tournament to go directly to the street racing. You have to do these completely in order. And once you complete these, you're able to go back with any car. So now that I've unlocked the street car, I could go back to the Spark Plug tournament and do the time trial again. And likely pretty much ace it, just because I'm running a leveled up car, or a leveled up second tier car. It makes the early cars a little obsolete, especially I imagine once you get the third tier. Like I said, I haven't unlocked it, so let's drive for a little bit, and this gives us a good chance to take a look at the game. It is not a bad looking title for a budget game. I mean, it's not amazing, but it's definitely not an ugly game. Something else that they do that's a little bit actually welcomed is that you may notice, okay, I just picked up a power-up there, and during the time trial, all the power-ups are turbos. I picked up a second one, and it changed my turbo to a powered-up version of it. I kind of like that. It makes it so that you have a little bit of risk reward with using your weapons. Do you want to use that weapon right away, or wait a little bit to get a powered up version of it? And in this, it's probably best to be very liberal with your usage of turbo. So didn't mean to stop completely there. And there we go. I mean, I completely aced that. I was 7 seconds ahead of the 3-star time. Without really even paying that much attention to it. And if I was running my tier 1 car, this would be very difficult for me to hit the 3-star time without, you know, really using those turbos. So it does make the previous car, the tier of cars, very obsolete, unfortunately. So let's go ahead and take a look at another game mode. Actually, let's jump into the second tier of challenges. Okay, taking a look at this, there's another problem that I have with the game, and I understand why they've done it this way, because it's prolonging the game, is that you don't have a choice of what to do here. You have to complete all the events on each tier. You have to complete this hot lap and this pursuit mode. At least get 1-star in them before the next tier unlocks these 3 events. And it continues on throughout the tournament. It's done it for the previous 2 tournaments, and it's doing this for the 3rd tournament. And I understand that it's to prolong the limited amount, and that this isn't a AAA development team. This is essentially an indie team. I mean, they are indie. This is a self-published game. That said, it is very frustrating to hit a mode that I don't personally enjoy and be forced to play, even if the races are very short, which they are in this game pretty much overall, which is a bit of a downer in my eyes that the races are less than 5 minutes total. I don't think I've had a race that goes over 5 minutes yet. I'll go ahead and hit time trial again. I haven't had a fairly decent length race, and it makes these feel almost like popcorn levels. More the idea of a mobile game where, you know, you pick it up and play it real quick and then put it down, instead of a PC racer where you're investing time to learn the race, because there's really not a lot of reason to do so outside of just completion's sake. That's why I'm a little leery of the game's price tag. It is a $20 title on PC. I didn't research the price on the consoles, unfortunately. And honestly, this is a PC-centric channel, so I think you wouldn't expect me to have that price firsthand now that I really think about it. But you see, the one-star time on this race is 2 minutes 30 seconds, which... that's 2 minutes 30 seconds for 5 laps. That is a very, very short track. And the only way to really get anything close to a custom race is multiplayer. And I'll be perfectly honest that the one time I got into a multiplayer race, it looked like it was pretty much just random what you get. So it is a little bit of a disappointment. And the fact that the custom race mode is pretty much just multiplayer, and this is an indie title on PC, which 9 times out of 10, I think it's fair to say you're not going to see a huge consumer base for. It's like, see right there was a shortcut that you need the bouncy tires for, which may be a little case of more experienced players getting a huge power advantage. I'm not 100% sure on that yet. So that may be a detriment to multiplayer on consoles, where I expect the multiplayer scene to be a little bit more live, just because they can't go back and play Revolt. Their list of titles begins and ends with this for a toy-style racing game. So let's go ahead and do the elimination race and see how we do there. This is more combat focused, thankfully, so we'll have a hopefully see the AI just ganging up on me, so you can see what I'm talking about. Overall, though, it's not a bad looking game. I do like the stylized look. It is a little bit off-putting, some of the scale of things. It feels like they couldn't quite figure out what they wanted the scale of these cars to be. You know, like RC cars or like micro machines or whatever. So it's a little bit odd there. Oh, my first real use of a weapon in this video. Oh, you see that on the left? I just passed it, that coin. That is a way to get around some of the grind in this game, as I take a cheaty shortcut. You're allowed to... or you pick up those coins and you get extra money. But the problem is that most of those coins, like right there, that silver one on top of that shortcut, that requires the bouncy wheels, which is a very expensive thing. I'll try to remember to pick up that coin on my next time around. But some of the coins I've seen are pretty much you pick them up and you lose the race because there's just no way to get to them. And then even with catch-up mechanics, there is a power-up that I've only seen whenever I purposefully fell behind. That is essentially this, like the shrink ray from Mario. Oh, there we go. And then I completely miss it. Yeah. I would have done better to not pick up the coin. We'll do that again. Actually, I'll try to pick up the coin early so I can make up any round I lose. I've seen a power-up that's like the shrink ray, but I've literally only seen it whenever I purposely fell behind just to see how strong the rubber banding and the catch-up mechanics are, which there are strong catch-up mechanics in this game, at least for versus AI. Versus players, 100% sure on that, because like I said, I've only had one multiplayer race and pretty much everyone stayed pretty close together. Oh, there's the AI just completely dicking me over. I'm not sure if that was the AI not paying attention. Oh, I didn't have a good angle on that. I'll have to try to get it the next lap. I'm not sure if it's the AI trying to get back to its pathfinding and just being oblivious to me. Oh, as I land on the car and get bounced off the level. Not doing too well here. I complain about the game's difficulty and I'm going to lose here on a... Yeah, I've pretty much lost. Well, we'll see how strong the rubber banding is. Or, no, we'll just... I wasn't going to get that coin anyway. I'm not sure why I'm not hitting a retry. Oh, where was I going with that? I think I need to pay a little bit more attention to this, because Elimination and Pursuit are actually two of the tougher game modes. Outside of that, I found the game kind of easy overall. Elimination, just because the game can dig you over where the AI just gangs up on you. Oh, missed there. Oh, there was another coin right there I've never even noticed before. Okay, we'll pick this up. There we go. And then I'll lose because of it. Well, that's a good example of it, you know. I'll pick up 10,000 coins and lose the race on it because of it. But we could retry. Oh. I will say that trying to talk and play a game, especially a racing game, is kind of tough. Okay, now that I've no longer have my white whale or my copper coin, we'll see how I do. Oh. Actually, looking at that, it looks like there may be a way to get that silver coin without having the bouncy wheels. Because there was that highlighted, oh, shit. Box, which may allow me to get it. Oh. In their case, the AI just... I'm pretty sure they're just oblivious to my, oblivious to me. Okay, let's see what the... Oh, no. Huh. Yeah, I'm gonna lose this. Let's go ahead and quit out of this race and we'll do something else. Because I'm just not having any luck with it. We'll come back to that one. I'm going to pop into the drift mode, because drift mode in racing games has always been something that I've, well, loathed. But this one's actually pretty easy, which is good for me, because I'm not good at drift mode. But the fact that it forces you to go through these, some of the modes that you might otherwise not want to do, I think is also a detriment. So let's go ahead and pick up a few thousand points there. Okay. Oh, hit the wall and lose them. And we lose more points. Yes, I realize I'm not using the turbo because first of all, I kind of suck at controlling this to begin with. But one thing that is that they outright say that some cars are worse at drifting than others, and if you happen to pick a car that's not good at drifting, you are kind of shit out of luck unless you go grind for another car, because you can't skip these drift games at all, these drift modes. Now you see the event record, and I've never even come close to getting 3 stars. And it's not going to happen here again, I don't think. Ah! I had 20,000 on that, which would have put me close to my record, but oh well. Well, you just continue on. Now, handling-wise, I think you could see what I'm talking about. It not feeling like toy cars. It feeling more like full-size cars. Let's go back to the special events because they tend to be more interesting and see what we have here. These pretty much are just the standard races. This is about the closest you get to the custom races because you can choose oddball race combinations that you don't see the championship mode. But unfortunately, like I said, these are locked down big time. And they are limited. So let's just go ahead and... Actually, let's see if there's anyone around for multiplayer. Granted, I am recording this at stupid o'clock on a Saturday morning. Oh, there is one up. We'll see how this does. Only gotten one multiplayer game in so far, so this could be interesting. Oh, I may want to swap wheels and ready up. Granted, two people are a lot higher level than me, so I'll only do one of these just to see how it goes. But you can see this is the closest that you could get to a custom game mode. Come on. Yeah, I'm not going to sit here and wait too long for this. Just because it is a pretty standard race, so... I didn't really notice anything in my multiplayer game just out of the ordinary, outside of a little bit of lag on one of the cars, but that may have just been connection. Oh, here we go, finally. We'll see how we go with this. I do think that the only way that you are going to be able to really play multiplayer normal or at will is with a group of friends, and unfortunately, at least on PC, there's no way to get oh wow, there's a lot of lag in this one. And I get bounced off because of lag. Oh, this is not showing well for multiplayer, is it? We'll see if I can catch up, but I have a feeling that... Oh, there's the catch-up mechanic. But it doesn't last all that long now, does it? Yeah, there's some weird lag going on with this host. So that's all the more reason to not really play this for the multiplayer, to be perfectly frank. It's a little disappointing, to be perfectly honest. Like, there is no way for me to try to pass this guy. Because he is all over the road. Yeah, they do not do lag compensation all that well. What? I actually won that? No, it looks like I got... How did I get second when it said I was in first? Sheesh, yeah, that is just terrible, terrible lag. Yeah, that's a real downer that shows you just how bad the lag, or how poorly this handles extreme lag, it looks like. Granted, I have no idea of the pings of those guys, so it's hard to tell if it was just, you know, someone in Asia or something playing this or what. So it may not be representative of multiplayer, but the fact that I actually got a multiplayer game in this video is a little bit astonishing to me, because when I was trying during launch day, during prime hours, throughout the afternoon and evening on Friday, I did not find a single multiplayer game at all. Only found it during the night, so that tells me that it probably is going to be more popular in Asia because of the oddball times, at least on PC. I imagine that this game is going to be a lot more popular on consoles just because they have the captive audience. They can't go back and play Revolt. They can't go back and play, what's another one? A Toy Cars is another combat style RC car game that's on PC. That they can't go back and play those. So it is a more captive audience on consoles. So I imagine that they will see more numbers there. And I'm going to switch back to my normal tires and do, I think, one more race before we call this. We'll try that elimination race again. Unless I could spot another interesting race to try out, because there's at least so many modes. There's hot lap. Let's show up hot lap, actually. Yeah, 90 seconds, which, once again, very, very short events. It's the fact that events are so short, it just, it makes it feel like there's a lot less content than what there is. Now, I'm not asking for, you know, hour-long races of a a car game like this. But, you know, give me 5 minutes, you know? Maybe I'm just expecting more, you know, or I went into this with the expectation of it being similar to a Revolt, which, like we've gone over before, this game is of the same genre, but outside of that, it's not really Revolt. And I just noticed a possible shortcut over there, which I'll try to take on my next lap, because, well, I've already gotten 3 stars on this. Oh no, I need the bouncy wheels for that. That's another case of the, I think if there's a player that has the bouncy wheels, or, you know, that's leveled up enough to get them, that's going to be a almost overpowered item, just because there's simply no way to counteract them when they're able to take shortcuts like that. Because it looks like it takes a good chunk of the track off of this track. Or a good portion of the lap off this track. I'll try one last time. Oh yeah, not even close. I need those bouncy wheels. And you can see, okay, the bouncy wheels were 100,000, I believe, and I got what, let's call it about 2,500 out of that for first place. So yeah, that's quite the grind. Granted, it is account wide, so go over here, and yeah, I'm just looking for anything else that's really interesting. Should we try the elimination one last time? Yeah. We'll try it one last time, and then we'll wrap things up. Final thoughts. The game is actually very stylized. I like the look of it. There is a little bit of texture pop-in that I've noticed occasionally. I'm not 100% sure if it's just my machine or if it's the game itself. Because after playing for a while, I've noticed that it stopped. It's like a level detail thing where it'll go from a blurry, low-res texture from far away to a more highly detailed texture. I'm not a huge fan of just how light some of these objects are. Feels like the road hazards aren't much of a hazard. They're more of just an object in the road that could just be bumped around like wheel. That they don't really have that much impact. But, yeah, they're at most if you catch one the wrong way, it may throw you off course, and that's what slows you down. And maybe that's why the scale feels a little bit off. Oh, I just lost a lot of time there. Ah. Is that it feels like the objects don't matter. Oh, yeah, the AI just completely screwed me there. Oh, what a dick move. Yeah, and it didn't even need to go over that far. It just, you know, did it. You know, we're still wrapping things up, so, you know, try something else, I guess. Go for a pure race, see how that goes. With no weapons, which is a bit better, but... Oh, that is such a dick move, and that's definitely not the AI, you know, not detecting me. That's the AI purposely dicking me over. Ugh. Let's see, soundtrack, isn't my cup of tea music-wise, but I can recognize that it's not bad music. It's not, it does get a bit repetitive, but, you know, that's just music in general, I think, and eventually it would get old, but it's not so, it's not bad enough that, you know, makes me want to claw my ears out. Well, there's a ringing endorsement. Music's, it doesn't make me want to claw my ears out. I should say that it's not repeating so quickly that it's getting grating on me after a few hours of play, so you do have that going for you. I do think that the music is more of just a general loop and does have level-specific tracks. Or, you know, track-specific tracks. Which is, you know... A little bit of a disappointment. It just feels like it has a good base game. And I'm just a little concerned that everything else is going to be DLC because it came out with a day one DLC. And there's been a few people complaining on the forums. It's more of the vocal minority, but I do understand the frustration of it. Boy, I'm just whipping these guys. This is what happens when I get pure race. And this is with rubber banding, I might add. Where's that one that's just so far back? I don't know what's going on there. I guess those matchboxes actually need to get shot with a rocket now that I think about it to blow them up. Maybe we'll try a combat race and see that if that does it. Like right there, that was a little over 4,000, maybe 5,000 coins. So yeah, the grind is real in this game. And that said, I did unlock this car when I was in the second championship of the Cult Classics car. So, or the Cult Classics Cup. So. It's not having to play the same races over and over again. It's just... Well, in this case, it's literally one race that's holding me back. I'm not doing too well on this one race. And that's where the design, I think, really falls apart. And yes, I am trying the elimination again. Let's see if the AI dicks me over again. Overall, though, I'm not convinced 100% sure that it's worth the price tag of $20. I think this is more of a $15 title. You know, more of a budget racer than what they're selling it for. Because honestly, the $20 price tag for indie games, at least wherein I'm recording this, it could be completely different in a year or two, and I... actually kind of expect it to be. $20 is more the premium area for indie titles. So to see a racer that, you know, I'm over half, or yeah, well, not over, but yeah, about halfway through the championship content after just a couple hours. And honestly, racing titles usually have a pretty long shelf life of just, you know, going back and doing different tracks and trying to perfect things. So maybe I'm being a little overly critical, or maybe I'm just looking at this and thinking that there should be more to this title. And all of a sudden, I'm kicking ass, and don't ask me why. Maybe it's the idiot savant in me, or, you know, maybe I'm actually paying attention this time around, because I'll be perfectly honest, racing and talking is... Oh, yeah, there we go. It's definitely... I need to hit it with a rocket. Or at least some sort of explosive. Okay, there's another rocket. I'll try to hit that. Oh, I got one back there. So, that's how we get the silver coin. That's... Whoa, what happened there? Not sure what happened, but I need to burn my rocket to stay in the race. That was a little bit odd. Not sure if that was a bug or what. Okay, let's see if I can hit this guy. Yes, yes, I'm well aware. I'm not getting a clear shot. I've a little lost, but I got close enough that, you know, second is good enough to progress. Got 6,000 coins and 25,000 for the silver. So that's about the best way to progress. So, yeah. The Grand Championship, the Grand Prix final is a series of three races, three combat races, I believe. So, or at least it's been three combat races so far in the other two. So I'm not going to bother with that. Overall, I don't think it's a bad game. I think it lacks a little bit in content for its price tag. Particularly because it's lacking the custom races, and we saw the multiplayer. As a matter of fact, I'll get back to the multiplayer and see if there's any other races. Yeah, see, no games found. This is kind of the standard that I saw throughout the day. That was global, by the way. Actually, let's see what host game looks like. Yeah, see, and here's probably where the problem's going to lie, is that with the DLC, they are splitting their community. Because I don't have the DLC, so I'm probably not seeing anyone that's hosting with the Charger Pack, and which is the Day 1 DLC. And that is a fundamental mistake for indie games, is to split their player base. So, invite, yeah. And I can limit by levels, so up to mine and edit. Yeah, I don't have a choice in what levels to play or mode, so... Yeah, that's a little disappointing. But yeah, I didn't even realize that the multiplayer was splitting off players based on DLC, so... As there's more DLC that comes out for this game, particularly on PC, because it is going to be a smaller player base, that is just going to kill the multiplayer completely. Oh, that is... Yeah, do not buy this game if you're playing it. Or planning to play it with just random people online, because the community is not going to be there on PC. Maybe it'll be different on consoles, I don't know. I'm expecting it will be, but I can't say for sure, because I'm not a console player, so... this is a PC-centric channel, so... There you go. Oh, that really changes my opinion on this, doesn't it? Multiplayer is going to be... fragmented like crazy if they continue putting out DLC, which I don't know if they do well or not, or if it's just that one DLC pack that's going to change things, and you know, the rest is, you know, going to not have multiplayer interactions. I have no clue whatsoever. Lack of custom games is a big detriment. The fact that the championship mode, I've gone through half of it nearly. I have the finale left to do, and then I'm officially halfway through. And I want to say 3 hours. And that includes me just getting down and practicing with some of the cars to be able to play this a little bit better for you guys. And granted, I haven't really touched the special offense, so that might be where things are different. Oh, didn't mean to click out of that. But even so, these are still very short events. You know, there's a 7-lap elimination race, which elimination is probably the longest race now that I think about it. And that may be the 5-minute mark right there, is the eliminations. But even so, that's still not a lot. And I'm just looking here at combat elimination, another drift race, which with the Widowmaker. But, you know, you need level 11 for that, so I'm still... I can't... Can I do any of these if I had the car? Well, I could do one of these if I had the car, or had the proper car. That's a little annoying. And supercars. Level 15, level 15, level 15, level 16, 17. Yeah, so even to get to these, if my progression throughout the earlier stuff holds true, it's going to take a lot of grinding to get to level 18, which I believe is the upper level of this. And I know that the DLC does add more special events, as well as general tracks and cars, so it may have a higher level cap there as well, which, oh, that is very, very grindy. And I've realized that racing games are grindy by nature, just, you know, perfecting your routes and everything. But a combat racer, I wouldn't expect to be as much. It would be more just general nonsense and fun. And yeah, I'm not convinced that this is worth the $20 price tag on launch. It does have a discount bringing it down to just over the $15 mark, down to $16.99 on Steam. And that's probably where I would think that the game should be at default. There hasn't really been a great kart racer or combat racer on PC since Sonic All-Stars, now that I really think about it. And unfortunately, I don't think this is going to fill that void for a lot of players. There are going to be people that are going to look at this and pick it up. And I do think that isn't a terrible car game or terrible racing game. It's just probably not going to scratch the itch for a lot of people that want that Revolt experience again. I'll be perfectly honest. Looking at the store page, you would expect Revolt, and like I've said before, this is not Revolt, unfortunately. The search still continues for that genre. But let me know what you guys think. If you have any feedback for this, or just the Sunday Sampler in general, leave it in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this and don't really have anything to say, hit the like button because that does help. And subscribe if you see my Let's Play content, more of the Sunday Sampler, which may break away from the Quick Click series for a little bit, because we are going to be entering the summer slump. So we'll see what I get. I may go back to another game or do a short Let's Play series as part of the Sunday Sampler. I'm not sure on that just yet. I'll have to try to figure out something there. And outside of those two series, well, technically four series now that I think about it, there's also the podcast, which plays on Friday afternoons with my friend Gaming Psychologist. And that wraps up the Sunday Sampler for this week. As always, thank you for watching. And we'll see what happens for next week, because like I said, we're entering the summer slump. I'm not sure what's going to happen, but I'm sure it'll be interesting. Until then, I'll see you.